Jerusalem, on a dusty road, an innocent man condemned to death bore a cross on his shoulders. They did his name down the Via Dolorosa. He staggered in agony as he looked upon the hatred in the eyes of his own. See, they didn't know.
They didn't know he was enduring this for them, so they could live forevermore in paradise with him. They didn't know one day they sing his praise with fear and trembling. They didn't recognize the king that kings call king.
He didn't have to die for me. He could have just set himself free. He could have come down from the cross at Calvary.
But instead, he was wounded for our transgressions.
Oh. Stripes,
we are healed.
Oh,
oh,
oh, oh, oh, for me. They hung him high and stretched him wide. They nailed his hands and feet and pierced him in the didn't know. Look at my Savior hanging there, suffering, bleeding, dying for me and you.
Oh, the show. This is not a part of the show. So come on and give God some praise for the blood. Give God the praise. Give God the praise. If it has not been for the Lord, if it has not been for the blood, you would be out of your mind. Oh God, we thank you. God, we thank you. God, we thank you. If it had not been, just think, if it had not been for the blood, so many of us would have lost our minds. If it had not been for the blood, you wouldn't be standing here right now. God has kept you. It's all about the blood. It's all about the blood. It's all about the blood. All about the blood.
Think about how you couldn't make it here. Think about how a few moments to think about his blessings, think about his power, think about his blood, and you should be going off too. Hallelujah. Come on. The blood still works.
The blood still works.
Come on. Oh, we got a whole second half. Get off the stage, because we will be here all day singing about the goodness of our Lord. For those of you who don't know, this is our Olympics. This is our season. This is our Holy Week. And we're just excited that he died and he rose. Hallelujah. You better praise him, Brother Walter. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Are you having a good time? Are you having a good time? Pastor Bobby, please, we're going to give an offering and we're going to go right into our second half.
Amen. The gospel is free. The gospel is free. So the way you're going to worship now has nothing to do with you receiving the gospel. The gospel is free. That's why we didn't charge you anything to come in the doors tonight. There are many ways to worship. And in this house, we don't just worship with the music and the dancing and the preaching. We also worship with our giving. Many years ago, David, King David, the father of praise and worship, said, I will not give anything to God that costs me nothing. So he, thousands of years ago, understood that one of the most impactful ways that he could worship was to give. So we're asking you now tonight to join us in the worship by giving. You can't pay for what you're getting tonight, so let's put that aside. But you can do something to express to God how much you appreciate what he's done, what he's doing, and what he's going to do. And you can invest into the ministry that's going on in this house, because if you do that, you're sowing into good ground. Amen? Understand what we're about to do? All right, so our ushers are waiting for you. I'm going to ask for everyone to just, let's all stand together. We're going to pray together. For our visiting friends, we invite you to worship with us in giving, but you are not compelled to give. Everyone who's going to give tonight is going to give not grudgingly or of necessity, because God loves a... All right, so there's no pressure. There's no pressure. It's an invitation to worship God with your giving. Amen? Let's bow our heads and pray. Father, we just love you tonight. We thank you, God, for what you said. We pray, God, that you continue to speak throughout these next few moments. God, touch your people, Father, as they extend their hands to share. God, I just pray that your spirit would be on us, God, that you would show us and tell us what to give. And that, God, as we release what is in our hands to you, we pray that you would release to us a deeper understanding of your glory, of your majesty, of your great love for us. Help us to see the power of the gospel of Christ like we've never seen it before. As we extend ourselves, God, we're praying that you would extend yourself down to this room, that you touch every believing heart and every questioning heart, and that you shine a light on the cross of Jesus Christ so that all might be saved and come to a knowledge of the truth. So bless every hand that gives tonight. We even pray a blessing on those who are unable to give. And we pray, God, that you would smile upon us with your favor, your goodness, and your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Everyone said, amen. You may be seated, and our ushers will wait on you. No, they're going to march? Oh, you're going to march. I'm sorry. Well, you guys can remain seated if I got my BJ stuff right. Everybody else, please remain standing. Everybody else, please remain standing. Please forgive me. That's my other church ways. Old church ways. You're going to come as directed by our ushers. Amen. And let's sing something as we give. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah, you're worthy to be praised. 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 I lift my hands, I praise you, Lord.
Thank you.
As he turned, he saw the Christ with his blood flowing down. He knew he had found the one who could save his soul. So he cried,
thank you. What have I done? What have we done? I beat him, I spat on him, I tortured him for hours until he was unrecognizable. But don't blame me. It was not my fault. It was my job. It was my job. I knew this man was innocent. I knew it. Then our eyes met. And I felt his peace. He looked at me and I saw his love. Then I felt his forgiveness. What manner of man is this that would allow me to torture him all night long and he doesn't say one word? What manner of man is this that is ostracized and beaten and tortured and he does not retaliate in any way? What type of man is this that would allow his father's will to outweigh his own will? Truly, truly, this man was the Son of God.
My
blessed my soul, and he blessed my soul, and he blessed my soul. And he blessed my soul, and he blessed my soul, and he blessed my soul.
Jesus, he is in The blood still works. I am redeemed, bought with a price, and I'm standing up just in case you can't say that. Because the water is troubled. And if you do not know him, whom to know is life eternal, don't leave out of this house the same. We would love to pray with you. We would love to lead you to him who has washed us in that blood that still works. Is there one that is feeling the pull of the Holy Spirit? I would love to pray with you. I just want to remind each and every one of us that no one of us is getting off this planet alive. Unless the rapture. But you have to be ready. If you know you're not ready, oh sister, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I just want to touch your hand because we're becoming family in the blood. I would love to reach the, come on, I'd love to meet the rest of my family. If you are feeling the Lord telling you to come to Jesus while you have time, I would love to meet you. Is there one more that says, I cannot say without a shadow of a doubt that I am redeemed? Would you come to Jesus? Not to me, not to this church, but come to Jesus. Ah, I got another sister coming. Oh, bless God, I got another sister coming. Is there a brother in the house? Is there a brother? is your night. This is your day. I promise you, you'll never be the same. You'll never be the same because you're looking at someone who hated herself, hated people, but God saved me. He cleansed my mind. He gave me love. He gave me peace. He gave me to just live one more day, and I'll be with you. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes. Oh, I got some little sisters, too. I got some children. Mother, how you been? Bless you. Good to see you. God is going to increase. This house got a young brother. Oh, my Lord. God is doing it. God is doing it. Hi, brother. God is good. God is growing his family. God is bringing them in from the north, west, east, and south. Look at our family, Bethel. Come on, Bethel. Come on, Bethel. Give God some praise. Give God some praise. Don't give me any praise. Give God some praise. Oh, because we have a harvest. Look at the harvest. Is there anyone not feeling well? You have some prophecy. Oh, I have some more sisters sneaking up on me. Oh, I got a big family. Come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on. God is good. Let's get a little closer. Let's act like we know each other. Because we're going to be spending eternity together. Come on. Punch it. Punch it. I don't want to leave anybody out. I don't want to leave anybody out. Is there one more family member that needs to come home and step in the water? Bethel family, stretch your hands towards our new brothers and sisters, because we're going to pray in the spirit that not one of them will be lost. And on that great day when the Lord comes to take us home, they will still be in the number. Still be in the number. God bless you. Oh, my goodness. I got me another sister coming up here. Oh, Bethel, look how our family's growing. Look at how our family's growing. I need you to repeat after me. Dear Lord Jesus, I want you to come into my heart and save me of all of my sins. I've learned tonight that your blood still washes. It cleanses. It works. And I'm confessing with my mouth. And I'm believing in my heart that you are my Savior. And I'm going to walk away from this altar redeemed, born with the price, because Jesus has changed my whole life. I won't look back. I will study your word. I will find a house of worship. And I will serve you the rest of my days. Father, fill each and every one of them with your Holy Ghost. Father God, fill them with your Holy Ghost even right now, Jesus. Father God, even now their name is being written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And Father God, I pray that you would seal them, that you would protect them, that you will build a hedge of protection around them, Father God. And as you fill them with your Holy Ghost, that you will use them as ministers in the gospel, that they, Father God, will round up the harvest and the seed that you would have them to come in contact with. Because for the rest of their lives, they will lift up the name of Jesus wherever they go. I want you to declare with me, I'm saved. I'm saved. I'm saved in Jesus' name. You want them to come this way? I'm gonna follow them in this direction here. Did anybody come up for prayer and healing? Can you go in this direction? And some of you come after service and tell me your names. I want to hug on you. I want to love on you because I've been asking God to increase our family. Come on, Bethel. We got new brothers and sisters. God is increasing us. We have some for prayer and healing. Already you love Jesus. Oh, my Lord and my God. Brother Worley, I want you to come and pray for Noah. Send anointing all over him, and I don't want the enemy to trip him up, not one day of his life. This is Minister Worley. He's going to pray for you because you have already accepted the calling on your life. You could not see it where I was. You could not see the light over him. His hands were reaching to the sky, and I want those hands to remain lifted up for the rest of his day. No gang, no bully, no devil in hell. Now I want you to tell Sister Shayna what you want from God, and we're going to pray, and God will do it. And anoint her what you believe in God. You can tell her. Amen. Hallelujah, Father God, this is your daughter. You can do a work that no man can do. Give her what she stands in need of. Revive her from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet. Bless her. Bless her family. Bless her whole generation.
presence of the Lord in the room. Now you can really put your hands together and praise God. I didn't come with a list, but I'm going to try and do this real quick. I want to say thank you again to our Bishop, Bishop Crawford Brown. Is Bishop in the house? All right, well, everybody who knows Bishop should give a better clap than that. Okay. We thank him and the pastoral staff for signing off, for allowing us to, God bless you, Bishop, for allowing us to have this moment with you, this moment with God, this moment of reflection, remembrance, and celebration. We want to thank our lighting crew, Sister Trinice and everybody up there, Elder Darren Hicks, everybody in charge of our lighting crew, thank you so much for putting everything, hard work, long before we ever got on stage. We want to thank everybody from our sound crew, Sister Margaret Scriven, and the guys working back there, thank you so much for allowing us to be audible. I believe we also got some equipment from a friend, so we want to thank all those who contributed to helping us get the word out in the audience. All right, we want to thank our ushers who are here tonight, Sister Sandrina and the entire usher crew. Thank you for keeping everybody moving, for doing that needed to be done. There was a lot happening over this past week, and the DWP was through a lot. We want to say a special thanks to Elder Vincent Williams and the entire facilities and custodial staff for keeping this place looking so beautiful. Come on, put your hands together for them. I want you to put your hands together. You're hearing them now, but you're not seeing them. And I put these brothers through a lot, and they sacrifice a lot. Sometimes it's difficult, and many of you don't even know who they are. But there are a bunch of musicians in the back of the choir who've been helping us keep it going all night long. Come on, put your hands together for our musicians. Thank you all so much, Brother Teddy Robinson, Brother Brandon Porter, Brother Ruben Alvarado, Brother Judah Subraw, Brother Richard Rossi, Brother Paul Antoine, Brother Dayron Nisbet. We thank you all so very, very, very much. I want you to put your hands together for this fantastic choir. Fantastic choir. Lots of rehearsals, lots of work, lots of long Saturdays. God bless you all. Thank you so much. I'm gonna ask Warren to come, and I want him to do. Talk about him last, but I want him to give some thank yous, because you're gonna do it better than I am. All the folks who helped out with the production.
So everybody who was a part of the cast, everybody come on the stage really quickly. Dancers, actors, everybody, come. Everywhere, they're everywhere. Some up there, some in the back. Did you guys enjoy tonight? Then let them see how much you enjoyed tonight. Come on, you can do better than that. Let them see how much you enjoyed their hard work and their sacrifice. Hallelujah. I'm sorry my back is to you, but let me talk to them personally. I know I am not the easiest person to deal with. But year after year, production after production, you never cease to amaze me. I am so in love with your sound, so in love with your spirit, so in love with your sacrifice to this church, to this ministry, to God, that I would not want to do ministry with anybody else. I want to tell you that I love you from the bottom of my heart. I'm not crying. You won't hit me today. Really quick, let me introduce a few people. Let me give a Sister LaShawn Pat. She is the, come in. She is the director of the One Accord Dance Company here at this church. And they spend every Monday and every Friday rehearsing this music along with other responsibilities in the church. We are so grateful for your leadership, so grateful for your friendship and your love toward this ministry. To Brother Dwight Smith in the corner who played the thief on the cross. To our sister Thera Ward. And I'm gonna get this name right. To Sister Jabria Cofield. To our Mary Magdalene, Mrs. Niaja Turner. To our Judas, Nelson Conchella Brown. To Mary Jesus' mother, Miss Denise Burst Fernandez. To the town crier, Mrs. Crystal Harris. And to Peter, Mr. Corey Harris. We also have, I'll go to the last. We also have Chris King, who played two parts tonight. And we got my daddy. Here's my daddy. Who played the guard. Did y'all enjoy this little guy right here? So, quick story. This year, I did not have a guard at all. So here we are, Monday at rehearsal, and he's like telling Sister Nisi, I really want to be a part of the production. And I was like, okay, great, you're the guard. He's like, what? I was like, yeah. No, he's like, I'll do it next year. I was like, no, you're going to do it this year. I have a costume for you ready. Didn't he do an amazing job? Stepping in at the last minute. I love you, man. Who am I missing? Sister Sandra Huff. Been hearing her sing since I was a little boy, since I was 4 years old. Give it up for one of my soloists, Javon Roberts. Love him, I love the way he's grown up. And to this beast in the blue. Y'all let her hear it, Shekinah Montu! Everett Lee is somewhere up there. Everett Lee, he played Barabbas this year. To Trenise Ladson, to Jeremy Trott, to all of the sound and team, everybody, Sister Margaret, Timothy, Joshua, Jeremiah, everybody. And to this young man with this crown of thorns on his head. Let me tell you something. I won't tell how shady you were when we first met. Right, Percy? He was shady. He didn't even want to say hello. But I said, okay. I said, Percy, keep your dogs away, because I don't want to be his friend. And maybe 2 weeks after that, we started creating a bond. And the Jesus that we normally had, his schedule is busy because he's in graduate school, Brother Kendall Glassby. And so I was like, Lord, I need a Jesus. I need a Jesus. I need Jesus. Jesus, I need a Jesus. And I said, Percy, I said, can Mark act? And he's like, he went to school for it. He went to Rutgers University. And I said, well, you know, I'm going to ask him. And if he can act, I'm just going to try him out and see if he can come out here to New York and see if he can try it out. And I did not 100% put my faith in you until 2 weeks ago, he got on that cross and he did the final cry. And we were all sitting here like, and that's when I was like, okay, he's the one. I want to thank you for your sacrifice of driving out here every other day. Going back and forth to New Jersey. He had to preach this morning at his own church, I Thirst. And he came on out here. Man, I'm so grateful for our brotherhood, our friendship. You are one of a kind. You are one of a kind. And I can't call his legal name because he doesn't like it. So I'm going to call it by his stage name, which is Kadesh, which means consecrated unto the Lord. Y'all give it up for Kadesh one more time. Woo! And I'm done. Yes, so can you take it off for 2 seconds? Just help him, 2 seconds. So he got here today about 3 o'clock, and there was this young girl who I kind of have a friendship relationship with. We've kind of known each other for a really long time, and I begged. I said, we need you at our church to put this makeup on Jesus. Come here, old Megan Celeste. Come here. Can y'all zoom in and see the details? There's blood everywhere. There's flesh hanging off. This young lady right here, Omega Celeste Ruth. Omega, I'm so grateful that you were able to lend your talent. She not only has our service today, but she also has 3 services on Sunday where she has to do the same exact thing. And I want to thank you for giving of your time and not counting your robbery to lend us your talent and show us and teach us how to do this special effects makeup that you have in the bag. I'm so grateful for your love and for your friendship. It means everything to me. Thank you so much. To the one who I've gotten on her nerve every day. I know she probably wants to tell me off even now. Come in, Adrian. And to Sister Pat Soverall. Where's Sister Patricia Soverall? There she goes. Come. These are our wives. She's right there. They sacrifice so much so that we can be a part of ministry. And I say this every year, but my wife is a full-time mom, a full-time worker, and she's a full-time student trying to get her bachelor's and master's at the same time. She's Wonder Woman. She's Wonder Woman. If anybody's ever seen Superwoman, Wonder Woman, there she go right there. Baby, I love you. Thank you so much to our son, to my son Grayson and Ashton, and to Judah, and to Rebecca Soverall in the corner who sang this year for the first time. Woo! She has perfect pitch, y'all. She would get us together in rehearsal. Where's the y'all singing flat? Also, we cannot leave this place. Thank you to Elder Ruthann Winter, as well as thank you to our other minister of music, our sister Beverly Robinson. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And to our bishop in the corner over here. Y'all give it up for our bishop. Come close this up, bishop. It's time to go home. I just want to let you know that I got y'all out here at 9:25, and it's 10 o'clock, but it's not my fault.
Well, before Bishop closes out, again, to the gift that is here. He talked about his superwoman. God bless me with the superwoman also. But this young man, the brain child, the inspiration, the ideas, the supervision, God poured it all on him. And again, he comes through. Minister Warren S. L. Hicks. Thank you, Warren. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. Bishop.
Warren, please don't walk away. On behalf of the entire production of Voices from the Chorus, we present you with this for your family.
Well, let's all stand and let's put our hands together one more time for this fantastic group of talented, blessed individuals. And I spent most of the night walking around different corners in the back. I don't get a chance to see that much. And so I was standing up there in the balcony and just really been impacted by how the ministry from here was hitting. And we saw the fruit of that with the lives that came to know the Lord Jesus Christ tonight. So now put your hands together and let's give God all the honor, all the glory, all the praise. That the kingdom of God continues to expand as we share the gospel and give ourselves. Thank you for your sacrifices. They were here practically every day just coming and getting themselves together and doing so much. And we thank God for that. And the best is still to come. So grab the hand of a neighbor and let's just pray us out. Lord, we thank you again for all that our eyes have seen, our ears have heard, and the power of God that resonated in our hearts. As the story, it's an old story, but it never gets old. It rejuvenates us every time. When we think of the goodness of Jesus and what he has done for us. Thank you, Father, sticking with the plan. Because of that, we have life. We have it eternal. So, Lord, Sunday is coming and we're going to talk about that resurrection power. Be with us now as we'll just rejoice together on our way. Renew the strength of everyone who has part of their gifts and talents to your honor, Lord. Renew them, touch them. We come against any plan of the enemy to frustrate this night. That after all that has been said and done, that he'll try to put some kind of mark on it. But in the name of Jesus, we claim that protection, that covering. In the name of Jesus, it will be a good night. It will be a glorious Saturday, and we will rejoice on Sunday. Along with the rest of the kingdom of God on earth, as we herald, as we honor, as we proclaim, as we lift